अस्सलाम वालेकुम रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू। आई एम फरहाना मतीन फ्रॉम इकना रिलीफ न्यू जर्सी। वी जस्ट सेलिब्रेटेड ईद एंड अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह मेक अल्लाह सुबहाना व तआला एक्सेप्ट ऑल द इबादाज एंड वर्शिप दैट वी डिड इन रमदान। एंड आफ्टर सेलिब्रेटिंग ईद नाउ इन द मंथ ऑफ शवाल वी आर विटनेसिंग सो मच दैट इज़ हैपनिंग ऑल अराउंड अस इन द वर्ल्ड। We are listening to news. Some news are happy. Some good news. Some not so good news. And being human beings, we are affected by whatever we see or whatever we hear. So, being Muslims, our main responsibility, no matter what the situation of the world is to stay positive. This is the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said himself that I am the person who was tested most in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when we see the explanation that Sahaba had about the lifestyle of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we see that he was the most positive person. He used to smile the most. He used to be he was a very cheerful person. So when we look all around ourselves, whatever is happening in this country or outside of the country, being human beings, we are affected by it, and we should be affected by if the humanity is suffering anywhere. But the question is that what are we going to do about it? There are several ways we can deal with any problem. And being just ordinary human beings who are, you know, living in our homes, minding our own business, the least we can do is to pray for our brothers and sisters, despite of their race, their ethnicity, or their religion or anything. We should always feel sympathy, or I rather say empathy, for them. And we should remember them in our prayers and du'as. But the most important part that I am going to stress today is that we have to take care of ourselves also, not undermining the problems of the people, but from this perspective that if we take things seriously and are not positive, then the weight of the problems start bringing us down. And I started my talk by referring to or giving the example of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because he is our role model. And what we see in his life is that he had the most difficult life in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but his positive attitude was some of the things that Sahaba used to do, to feel that it was contagious. He would give hope to the people, he would give strength to the people, and this is basically the legacy of Anbiya alayhimus salam. And we are the followers of the Prophet, so we should always be positive. Despite of the challenges and hardships that are going in the world, we have to be positive, we have to be proactive, we have to we try to come up with ideas to bring peace in the world, to erase the pains of the people. But it can only happen if our own mind and our body is doing the right thing. If we are suffering physically for whatever reason, and if we are not taking life as we are supposed to be, then sometimes it becomes difficult for us to do the small chores, like, you know, our day-to-day life becomes difficult for us. So a reminder to myself, because I work in a relief organization and I get to see first-handedly the sufferings of the people, from hunger to homelessness to eviction notices to mental health issues, from, you know, variety of problems that human beings are facing everywhere in the world. And it takes a toll on all of us. It takes a toll on our mental health. It takes a toll on our emotional life. It takes a toll on our mood. But again, going back to the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how do we deal with these problems? How do we take these things that we do not undermine the struggle of any nation, any group, any people, or anybody who is suffering? But if we cannot stay strong, stay positive, stay healthy physically and mentally, we will not be able to help anybody. So this is a very tough time. The whole humanity is going through a very tough time. So a reminder to myself and to all of you who are listening out there, that try to take care of your health, eat good food, drink a lot of water, sleep properly, make lots of du'as, stay connected with human beings, and above all, stay connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Have high spirits, have good hope, because losing hope is not what Islam teaches us. We should always be positive about tomorrow, because Allah is taking care of this situation. No matter how hard the situation is for anybody, Allah is the one who is looking at everything. He knows everything. He is the in charge. So we have to put our trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, not undermining anybody's problem, not saying that, you know, everything is completely fine and, you know, if people are suffering, it is not, it shouldn't affect us. No, I'm not saying that. But the way, and especially, you know, alhamdulillah, and I would say alhamdulillah, I don't even say it enough, that we live in a world, or a part of the world, I would say, where our life is, subhanallah, much easier and much predictable than, I'm sure, rest of the world. There are so many other countries